Now, as water scarcity increases around the world, it will and already has begun to have implications for the public health of at-risk communities where access to clean water is scarce. Now, in Zimbabwe's capital city of Harare, water availability has steadily been decreasing, and the country is expected to suffer water stress by 2025. To help curb this, Harare's Doctors Without Borders Environmental Health Program has been leading two projects in Mbare and Stoneridge suburbs. The aim is to prevent disease outbreaks that can be prevented by protecting water at the source.
This is Greater Harare, a metropolitan area with about 4.5 million people, more than half of whom have no access to clean water and are at risk of waterborne diseases such as cholera and typhoid. It's midday on a Monday, and residents of Stoneridge, a poor suburb in Harare, have begun their desperate hunt for water. The taps at home dried up years ago. It's been a daily struggle for clean water in this area for many years. Communities rely on borehole and unprotected source of water. A long walk of desperation as women and children clutching water buckets search for water shows water stress. This woman here is Precious Kapesa. Like her peers, she has to walk far distances to get fresh water for her and her family. She says water in this area is contaminated and a cause of many diseases.
Kare vanhu vaichera mvura mumugodhi nepamwe panenge pasina kuvharwa saka zvaiita kuti vanhu mvura isina kuchena vanhu vaitombofa nezvirwere zvekorera natyphoid nokuda kwokuti vainwa mvura isina kuchena.
For residents living in this area, getting water means drinking from unsafe places in the area because raw sewage flowing on the ground will end up mixing with water sources, thereby posing a threat of waterborne diseases and diarrhea outbreaks. The water situation in Harare is largely the same as in 2008 when Zimbabwe experienced the most devastating cholera outbreak in Africa in 15 years. The outbreak killed 4,200 people and infected at least 100,000. Human Rights Watch found that the city's perennial water crisis is linked to the cholera outbreak. To help curb this, a team from Doctors Without Borders have started an initiative by building safe water sources and rehabilitating boreholes.
Being about 30,000 liters of water per hour, where the average borehole yield in Harare is merely 2,000 liters per hour.
To mitigate the continued outbreaks of cholera, the Doctors Without Borders are running a project to mitigate the risk of contaminated water waste by restoring contaminated septic tanks in the area, a move that has been hailed by the community.
When this project started, new decongestors were connected to this treatment center. So we now have all our waste being piped, so there's no contamination around and contamination of the water. We are so proud and humbled to have such a good system.
This far, the water project has placed 72 water distribution points in Harare, equipped with submersive solar-powered pumps and tank systems. Zimbabwe continue to be in a grip of water crisis due to poor rains and drought. Most local authorities have been forced to ration water. But the real fear is that the situation doesn't look like improving anytime soon. Bongani Siziba, News Central.